Today we're going to make your Plex Media Server accessible from outside your home, from anywhere you have an internet connection. There's a simple way to do it, and a more advanced way which involves port forwarding, and I'm going to show you both. With remote access, you'll be able to watch your Plex Media on a boring car trip or during a visit in town on your cell phone. This ability to remotely access your Plex server does not require paying for Plex Pass. If you're currently using Plex in your home, you probably have your media shared among several devices in your home, like your smart TVs, Roku streaming players, your Xbox or PlayStation, tablets, phones, or other computers. But this is on your network inside your home. What if you wanted to access your server from outside the home? I assume most of you will have a broadband modem that you use with your internet service provider. I assume that you have it connected to a wired or wireless router to which you connect all your computers and other devices that need access to each other and out to the internet. Now, if you have a modem/router combination from your service provider, you have something called a double NAT situation, where you essentially have two routers connected in a row, which is out of the scope of this video. So I'll assume you have a simple modem. You probably have one or more computers connected to the router, your Plex server being one of them. You might have a couple tablets, a few cell phones, some gaming consoles, and don't forget your smart TVs. Every time you connect a device to the router, it assigns a number or an IP address to that device. And each time you power something off and on, you may see a different IP address assigned to that device. This can also happen when you disconnect one device and connect a different one. But in order to forward a port on the router, you'll want your Plex server to have a fixed, static address so that even if you turn it off and on, it always has the same IP address. The quickest automatic way to enable remote access is to simply check the option to enable it during the setup of the Plex Media server. This assumes you have universal plug and play on your router. Think of the router as a wall that separates the modem, which is the interface to the internet, from the Plex Media server on your local network. Universal Plug and Play, or UPnP, opens a port through that wall on your behalf. After you install the Plex Media server on your computer, you'll want to load it in a browser for the first time by double-clicking the Plex icon in the taskbar. After you sign up for a Plex account and log in, you'll be presented with some introduction screens, including an offer to upgrade to Plex Pass. Let me exit out of that, and on the following screen, you'll be prompted to name your server, and finally, the checkbox to allow me to access my media outside my home. The easy, automatic way to share your media is to keep this box checked. Should you have unchecked it during setup, you can always turn it back on after installation, which I'll demonstrate next. Let's skip the final setup screens so we can get to the procedure. You'll want to click the setup icon and navigate to Remote Access on the left-hand side, where you'll find a button called Enable Remote Access. Simply click that button, and after a while, you should see a message in green that states, Fully accessible outside your network. If you don't see it, then that means your router has UPnP disabled by default, in which case you can log into your router and enable it, or the router simply doesn't support UPnP, or otherwise has a faulty implementation of it. Now let's talk about the advanced manual way to enable remote access to your Plex Media server. If you're using your computer and your router out of the box, it's most likely that your Plex server is on a machine that has an IP address assigned to it by a DHCP server on the router. We talked about this before. If we want to port forward, we need the Plex machine to have a static IP address. When you look at the big picture, the entire universe of IP addresses on a typical subnet mask is theoretically 256, from .0 to .255. Since 0 and 255 are reserved, the theoretical maximum number of devices that you can connect is 254, including the router. The DHCP server on the router can automatically assign a portion of these addresses, while you can manually assign the rest if you wish. We can even reach inside the pool of DHCP addresses and make one of them static by associating the IP to that one specific device, which is exactly what we'll do later on. We can see from our previous exercise that my Plex server uses an IP address of 192.168.1.33. I personally use a router called the Ubiquiti EdgeRouter Lite, so I'll show its interface in the following scenes. Depending on the router that you use, your screens will vary. To log into the router, I use Ubiquiti's default of 192.168.1.1, but your router may have a different address, like 192.168.0.1 or 10.0.0.1. You'll need to look up your router's documentation for its default address. So the first thing we need to do is to assign a static IP address to the computer on which the Plex server resides. There are a couple ways to do that. One is to manually set the IP address on the computer itself, one that lies outside the DHCP pool of addresses. This requires you to set up every single device that you want static and enter a manual IP in its network settings. The second way is to map the unique MAC address of a device to one of the DHCP pool of addresses, and you would do that in the router, not the device. In my case, for the Ubiquiti router, I'll tab over to Services. For my local area network, I can view the information about the DHCP server from the Actions dropdown, where I'll select View Leases. This shows me that I have a pool of IP addresses from .3 to .49, which will be automatically assigned to any device that asks for a dynamic IP. With my router, I can change the size of this pool manually. Depending on your router, you may or may not be able to change this range. Returning to the first tab, there's a list of every device on my network that's assigned an IP by the DHCP server, including my Plex PC. All I need to do is click the Map Static Address button to link the assigned IP to the unique MAC address of the network card in my computer, and save. This guarantees that my Plex server will always have an IP of .33. This feature may be called something else on your router, like DHCP Reservation or DHCP Static Lease, but they all essentially have the same function. Next, let's forward a port on the router. I'll tab over to Firewall NAT, where I can add a rule. I'll set the public port to 32400, but you can set it to any port between 20,000 to 50,000. I'll set the protocol to TCP, the forward to address to 192.168.1.33, and the internal forward to port to 32400. And this has to be 32400, which is the hard-coded port that Plex uses. Finally, I'll type in Plex for the description, hit the Apply button, and we're done. Now we need to go back to the Plex server and manually set the public port, which I'll set to 32400. Again, you can set this to any valid port, but this would need to match the public port that you just set on the router. Let's hit Apply. Sometimes you may need to log out and log back in to see the correct status of a remote access, but it looks like it is displaying correctly without having to log out. The final step is to disable universal plug and play on your router, but this step is entirely optional. You could keep your UPnP on or turn it off, and it shouldn't affect your manual port forwarding. But I need to caution you that if you have other devices in your home or other programs that depend on UPnP, like some IP cameras, smart LED bulbs, some games or applications, you may find certain things suddenly lose remote access when you turn off UPnP. They'll also need their own static addresses, and you'll need to forward their ports just like we did previously for Plex. Since we've already forwarded the port for Plex, that connection would remain. To turn off UPnP on the Ubiquiti router, you'll need to tab over to Config Tree and find the UPnP service. Now, the Ubiquiti EdgeRouter Lite has UPnP turned off by default, so I actually turned it on before I started this video, just for the purpose of this demonstration. On some routers, it'll be turned on by default, and most of the time it's just a checkbox that you need to uncheck to turn it off. In my case, I simply click on this little minus sign and hit Preview. And you can see UPnP is now turned off. Let's return to the Plex settings and confirm that remote access is still on. After clicking Apply, it is indeed still working without UPnP due to the port forwarding. A quick note about Universal Plug and Play. As we saw before, it's a very convenient feature that allows you to set and forget, which relieves you of having to worry about port forwarding at all. But with its ability to open ports through the router's firewall, there are security concerns, especially with malware. You'll need to determine whether the trade-off is worth it, but in general, the recommendation is to turn UPnP off. If you encounter any problems, I highly recommend Plex's Troubleshooting Remote Access page. It has additional details about double NAT situations and issues with jumbo frames. The convenience of having your Plex media available anywhere is obvious. You can watch your movies or TV shows while you're on vacation, or listen to your music collection while you're traveling. Here, I'm 200 miles away from home, and while I'm connected to the hotel's wireless internet, I can log into my Plex account on my tablet or phone to watch or listen to all the media on my server at home. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.